Hello, my name is Eric, and I'm going to tell you something about my Hewlett-Packard calculator collection.
And this is part two of the history of Hewlett-Packard calculators. The first part showed the LED calculators. If you're interested in those, make sure you have a look at that video. And today we're going to talk about the second part of the history, the LCD era.
A nice invention was done in LCD, liquid crystal display, as we all know it. And Hewlett-Packard started creating LCD display calculators from 1979 onwards. 1979, July of 1979, Hewlett-Packard introduced the HP41C. That's a monumental calculator. It was very popular, and the reason was that it was extremely programmable and expandable. The way it was expanded was because it had plug-in modules. As you can see, this one has a quad memory module. There were some dummy plastics inside, and you could put other expandable packs inside. These were sold like this. You have a math pack. So it came, of course, with the pack. You could put that in. And it also came with keyboard overlays. And those keyboard overlays could fit over your keyboard, so you could see what the new assigned functions were because of the added programs. There were many packs available. I have this one, this math pack in the box, but here are some other examples. I don't know what these are. X functions, time module, thermal. So there were many specific programs available. So that was great. People didn't actually have to program themselves. What they also introduced, which was very important, was this thing, the card reader, and writer, of course. It had the same plug as at the packs, and of course it fitted in your calculator by putting it in the right slot. And it neatly clicked like this. And then you had a card reader. And for the card readers you had these programmable magnetic cards. These magnetic cards slotted in here, and then later on put this here so that you could see what the added programs were. So what you often see is people having loads and loads of these programmable cards. I said it was a very popular calculator, and sometimes people have many, many stacks of these program cards, just like we had later on floppy disks for computer, etc. As time progressed and this took a flight, Hewlett-Packard created other versions of it. So this calculator, as I said, was introduced in July of 1979, but in the 80s, in 1981, they introduced the 41CV, and the V stands for 5 times the memory. And then 2 years later, in 1983, they created the 41CX, and you guessed it, the X stands for 10 times the memory. So these are the three 41s that Hewlett-Packard created. They also have the printer, of course, with the same interface as the program cards. You could buy paper for it. Here you can see it is not for the earlier 97 program printing calculator that I showed you, but it is for this this printer. And on a personal note, because I was connected to the right people, I got this keychain of the 41C. It shows you how monumental these calculators were. The 41C is extremely important, and I will get back to you later on when they introduced early 90s the 42. In the early 80s, 1981, 1982, during the success of the HP41, Hewlett-Packard also created another very nice series of calculators. It was internally known as the Voyager series. Out of the series, three are in what you could call a normal general purpose calculators. And these are the 10C, the 11C and the 15C. 10C, this is the 15, or the, sorry, the 11, and this is the 15. The problem with the 10C was that it didn't differ that much from its bigger brother, the 11, which makes this a very rare calculator. It was too expensive. People just opted for the 11 and or the 15. A bit later, they created the 16C. And if you now go on an online auction, you will see that the 16C is extremely valuable. This because it is for computer science, so it's actually called the 16C computer scientist. I'm very happy to have this boxed and with a nice manual. So it had functions like binary, octal, hexadecimal calculation as well, and other stuff that is special for computer scientists. Another very popular calculator is that Hewlett-Packard actually created the 12C, which is a business calculator. So it could calculate mortgages and other things that business people have to know. This calculator is the only one of the series that is still being produced. And as you can see, this package is rather modern. So this is from the modern version. And here I have three different versions of the 12C. You might not immediately notice the difference, but the first one was more silver colored, then it came into a more gold tint. I guess that is nicer for the business people, they want the gold. And then the later iteration, you could see from the back that there are changes in that they have the CE numbering, and it was ultimately produced in China. So this is a very modern version, and also a different. Trying to follow up on the success of the 12C business calculator, Hewlett-Packard created the 18C business consultant. Clamshell design, 1986 they introduced this calculator. So it was a very nice design and very sturdy. But as you know, the 12C is still in production, so they were never really able to replace the 12C. People were just constantly asking for that 12C. So although it is a very nice business calculator, it was never that popular. What Hewlett-Packard did was, 1 year later in 1987, they introduced a scientific calculator, the 28C. And the 28C, it only had 2 kilobytes of memory, but it had a big graphical display. I forgot to mention that about the 18C as well, so it could create graphics, etc. on it. The 28C had that same display, same form factor as the 18C, and it was an overwhelming success. The only problem with the 28C was that it, due to it has limited memory, only 2 kilobytes, while it really wanted big programs, if you wanted to do nice graphical things, the memory was insufficient, and they followed that up with a later model I will show you now. Hewlett-Packard really searched and created the 28S model, and it has a the same design as you could see, but it had much more memory. And it was extremely popular and it created a rather revolution. To give you an idea about how many functions and how many possibilities there were, this is the owner manual that came with it, and this is the reference manual. So both these manuals came with this calculator to show you how advanced this calculator was, how much you could do with it. It was revolutionary at the time. Yeah, 1988 was a special year. They never in the earlier has Hewlett-Packard introduced so many calculators in such a short notice. They created some other scientific calculators during the same time as the 28S. They were called the 22S, there was the 27S, and the 32S. So these are not the RPN calculators that were known for Hewlett-Packard, but they were algebraic calculators, and I forgot to mention that of the 18C as well. So it works with an input key and but not an enter, so you just do algebraic math on it. And maybe that's why they couldn't replace the RPM model 12C. The 32S though is RPN scientific. So you can see there is an enter key and not an equal key. And they created this RPN scientific model. Then, as I said, the 41 was still in production also. Packard couldn't get rid of the old models. The 41 was still so popular, the 12C was still so popular, and they just couldn't stop them because they were so popular. But they did try to replace the 41 with this one, the 42S. So same format as the other Lundy lines, and the 42S was meant as a direct replacement of the 41. Well, that didn't work. It was somewhat popular and some people really liked it, but of course it didn't have the same expandability as the 41 had. So you couldn't fit your program packs, you couldn't fit your card reader, and you couldn't read your card, so it might function the same, but you had to program it way different. What Hewlett-Packard did introduce was infrared printing. Already with this, there is an infrared LED at the top. The 28 model have it as well. And some of these models have this as well. So this battery compartment is actually see-through. Here you can see an infrared LED as well. So I'm not sure if the camera picks that up, that this is very dark purple see-through plastic, but the infrared LED could go through that plastic, and the infrared LED was used to print on a infrared capable printer that I will show you. In 1986, as part of the new series, Hewlett-Packard already created this infrared printer. It is the HP82240A, and the later model in 1989 is the 82240B. It is a portable printer that you could put batteries inside. It receives via infrared the things you wanted to print. So you just line up your calculator, and you could send the print command to this printer, and you could wirelessly print in the 80s already to this thermal printer. You could put batteries inside. The adapter was optional. But it was very popular for the 4A model, because only the 4B model actually went to standby after 10 minutes. That was the big difference. And it also had an extra character set, I think. So it was a very minor difference. And of course, you could buy boxes of rolls of thermal paper to put in these printers. In 1989, Hewlett-Packard also created a very cheap model of their calculator, the 20S. Also algebraic, you can immediately spot that on the input key, or you could spot the equals key. Because, yeah, it, even though they had great calculators, they were rather expensive. And I remember that in the Netherlands, this one was the first under 100 guilders, if I remember correctly. 1 year later, they followed up on their business type of calculators with the 17B2. The 17B I don't have, it was introduced 1 year before. For business, also an equals key. So, also for the business, they created another clamshell version of the 19B, also with more memory, the 19B2. So direct descendant for the what was the 19B. Then 1 year later again they created an RPN scientific calculator, and this became very popular because of its the pricing as well. So this one you will see more often, and it was still in production at the end of the 90s. In a slightly different format. You can see it modernized the look a bit, but for the rest it is the same calculator, but this one created end of the 90s and this one in 1991. Following up on the success of the Hewlett-Packard 28S, the Hewlett-Packard thought, okay, let's create the best graphical and scientific programmable calculator that we can, no limits, and they created the extremely expensive and extremely great Hewlett-Packard 48SX. So it is a rather big calculator. You could see, hey, they replaced the infrared LED with a receiving LED on the side as well. There was a serial connector. And there were also expansion slots. And of course Hewlett-Packard sold memory cards like this to fit in this expansion card. The calculator came with a big set of books with two parts. They also created, just like with the 41, other software. So like this Solve Equation Library. This is not a RAM card, not a memory card, but this is a ROM card. So an equation library card, you could slide that in as well. That you had two slots and you could add extra functions to the calculator. What was great was that other companies also started to create cards for functions. One of the companies that created these things were Sparkom. And they created stuff like this Celestial Navigation Pack, the Physics Pack, and as you can see it looked rather identical to the Hewlett-Packard ones, but yeah, the third party software that was created for this calculator. 48SX was introduced in 1990, and because of its popularity it also followed up later in the 90s with the 48G type series of calculators and the 48G Plus. So let me put them side by side. You can see, well, they changed the coloring somewhat. There was more memory and it was a bit faster, of course. And during the same time, Hewlett-Packard started to create DOS-compatible palm tops, what they called. So it was the same calculator factory that originally designed these, started to create these, and you could still see a bit of that form factor here. But the 95LX with spreadsheet, Lotus 1-2-3 built in, QWERTY keyboard was the first to first DOS compatible computer that Hewlett Packard created. Soon followed up with I think the 100 and this thing, the 200. Yeah, and with that, at that time, the calculator factory in Corvallis in America was closed because of budgetary problems, and Hewlett Packard stopped for a while innovation in their calculator business. They moved all their production to Singapore and later to China, some to Brazil even. The people that were creating these inspired calculators, they stopped working for Hewlett Packard. Of course, later on, Hewlett Packard introduced some new calculators, but I wanted to cut off here. This is where my collection ends, because I think with the advent of the 48 and maybe the DOS type of palm tops, that's a logical end to an era of very nice, very creative, and very noteworthy calculators. So that also ends this video. I hope you enjoyed it, that you liked seeing my small collection. And if you have any additional information, or if you have any comments, please write them down in the comments. I really appreciate hearing from you if you like this. And thank you very much for watching.